Welcome back, Ring Toss Champions.
You know, I was thinking about our carnival game experiment from last time, and I think we're getting pretty good at using the engineering process to come up with a solution to a problem. So, good for us. Now it's time to mix things up a little. Sometimes, engineers figure out more than one way to reach a solution to a problem. Think about our trip to the bowling alley. In order to solve the problem of getting a strike, we use the ball ramp for every trial. But what if someone else in another lane was waiting to use the ball ramp? Engineers aren't just brilliant at solving problems, they're also excellent at sharing. So, in general, what if you don't have what you need, whether it's the necessary equipment, or the right materials, or enough money, to make a certain solution that works? It means you gotta come up with another solution. And that means you have to be able to test a bunch of different possible solutions that all meet the same criteria. So, how do engineers design multiple tests of different solutions that produce the same outcome? Let's head back to our ring toss game and see. We decided that the criteria for our solution were first, that we need to get the ring around the pin, and second, that we need to do it in one toss. Next, we thought about the variables that could affect our outcome, like the size of the ring, the height of the pin, how we tossed the ring, and how far away we were from the pin. After some thought, we decided to isolate the ring size as our variable. And it was go time. We did three trials using a small ring, a medium ring, and a large ring. And it took the large ring for us to get the outcome that we wanted, and a sweet grand prize. But that's not all. Being good engineers, we kept testing our solution until we found a failure point. We learned that if we changed another variable, our distance from the pin, the large ring wasn't going to solve the problem anymore. Which is okay, because I only have room for one huge stuffed platypus in my room anyway. But let's try to find a few different methods we could use to get the same results. And let's not only make a plan, let's also make some tables. Tables are a great way to keep everything organized because we're going to be doing a few different tests, and we need a way to keep track of which variable we're changing in each test. Now, the criteria for our solution are the same. One ring, one throw, on the pin. Booyah! So next, let's list our variables. They are ring size, distance from the pin, the height of the pin, and how we toss the ring. Overhand, underhand, or like a frisbee. Now we need to pick a variable that we want to isolate. We already did the ring size, so let's choose the distance from the pin. So for our three trials, we'll change how far away we stand from the pin, making it 1, 2, or 3 meters. Now we have to keep all of the other variables the same, so let's decide what those are going to be. Let's choose the small ring, the medium height pin, and to throw the ring underhand. Okay, little Sabrina, start tossing. When we do our trials, we see that we get the outcome we want when we stand 1 meter away from the pin. Test one is complete. For our second test, let's change the height of the pin between trials. So we'll switch between throwing the ring at a short pin, a medium one, and a tall one. We also need to pick what we're going to use for the variables that don't change. Let's stick with the small ring and standing 1 meter away from the pin and tossing the ring underhand again.
Ready, little me?
This time we can see it's the tall pin that gives us the outcome we're looking for. Okay, last test. This time round, let's change how we toss the ring between trials. So we'll throw it underhand one time, overhand the other time, and the last time like a frisbee. And all three times, we'll use the small ring, the tall pin, and stand 1 meter away.
Ready, set, toss.
When we do our trials, we see it's the frisbee throw that gets us the outcome we want.
Now, if we wanted to, we could mix and match to create any combination of variables that we were curious about. Like, we could try the frisbee toss with different pin sizes, or toss the ring differently, but only use the short pin.
As long as we only change one variable at a time and still get the outcome that meets our criteria, we're totally golden. And now we know that it's possible to design several different tests that lead to the same outcome. We just have to remember to make a plan, to change only one variable at a time, and to keep things organized.
When in doubt, use engineering to solve problems. It'll pass the test every time.